Warm welcome to you into God's house. In His presence is the fullness of joy. Shall we say joy? Joy. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Is that good? Everybody likes joy? Yes, there's joy in the house of the Lord. Wonderful, isn't it? And you are in the right place and at the right time. And today, be in expectation that God will touch you with His precious word, and He will reveal Himself a little more than we've known Him before. Is that good? Shalini revealed to us that as she was preparing in prayer, that she saw lamps lit in this place, isn't it? That's the lampstand of God. Amen. That God is in the midst of us, and if God is for us, who can be against us? And blessed are the people who have God in their midst. That is everything for us, His presence. This morning we want to host God's presence. Is that good? You like to be a host, that present, that hosts the presence of God. Wherever you go, go in and come out, God will be with you all the time. Wonderful Father, in Jesus' name we thank you. We can give ear to your word. We pray that you will break the bread of life to us, and you eat, and the word of the Lord will be, Lord, manna to our spirit, our soul, and even our body. God sent His word and healed diseases. As we hear, Lord, we want the word of the Lord to be internalized and work in our inward parts. In Jesus' name, Amen. And at the end of the service, we have two important announcements. One by Nirmalani regarding a vision she has about a Samaritan box. And one by Manomi, young youth leader. Shall we give her a hand and affirm her ministry in the midst of us? Where's Manomi? Will you stand up, Manomi? Yes, wonderful. Let's welcome her. Let's bless her. Let's receive her as the leader of the youth team. Anushka, we like you to stand. They will be married in January next year. And we expect wonderful things out of this precious couple, isn't it? Shall we say God bless you to them? God bless you. Wonderful. Thank you so much for taking over, giving your shoulder to the plow. God bless you. And now for the word. So when we open the scriptures, everybody has a Bible. These modern days, people read the scripture out off the screen, but in the old-fashioned way, we were all taught to bring our Bible to the house of God. Good habit, that is. Right? Now I'm going to make you wave your Bible. Is that good? Right. Will you wave your Bible? Wave it. Wave it. Hold it high. Oh, those who didn't bring it. Okay, next time. Right? Next time. We're going to wave the Bible. Is that good? Yes. Wonderful. So, when we have the Bible, we can read, everyone is encouraged to read the scripture, isn't it? Because this, we know, is the inspired word of God. And out of this word, He speaks to us. He gives us instruction and He gives us counsel. If we don't read the word, we will be left to our own wisdom. We'll have to lean to our own understanding, and then that is not going to be great. Okay, and so we are always encouraged to read the scriptures, right? So when we read the scriptures, the word initially is like milk to us. Who drinks milk? Little babies. We have Saman and Amali's little one, we have Aisha and Sean's little one, and we have Manoj and Sashnika's little baby, right? So those babies are given milk, isn't it? Yes. So milk is what you get when you are fed. Like a mother feeding her baby. That's what we... But you know, we can't always live on milk only, isn't it? We need a little stronger food. We need solids. So meat is what you get. How? When we hunt for it. Isn't it? Meat won't come for free. Somebody has to hunt for the meat. So this morning, I like to arouse your curiosity or your hunger for the word, so that there will be mighty hunters in this house of God. Is that good? Can you see yourselves hunting for the word of God? Not only waiting for the preacher to come with a bottle of milk and feed you once a week. That's good, that will be done till the end of time. But we want, I want, I like you to hunt for the word of God, so that when you consume the word like that, you hunt for it, you search the scriptures and you receive the word, then what happens is you become stronger in the word of God and we become mature. We go from maturity to maturity. Otherwise we'll always be baby Christians. Okay, but good to be babies, we begin there, but we need to go on unto maturity. So when we learn to hunt for the meat of the word of God, you will also learn to feed yourself, not only to be fed. And that's my heart this morning, that to instill a passion for the word of God, young and old, everyone. Okay, a passion for the word of God. So the Bible is not a fence. We think, or that's the common understanding, the Bible is like a fence, it's all do's and don'ts and a boundary. Yeah, it is a boundary, it's a good boundary, right? It doesn't allow the things that are out there which is not good for us to come in, and the good things the Bible will not allow to slip out of our lives. So the Bible is a boundary, but it doesn't fence God in, it doesn't contain God. Do you get me? It doesn't contain, it doesn't limit God, because but the Bible, the scriptures reveal God to us, shows us the more of the God, of the God we worship, the more of him. And the scripture, we call all the, when we put all 66 books together, we call it the canon, or the canon of scripture. And the scripture is designed to lead us into an encounter with the Lord our God, a meeting, a closer meeting with the Lord our God. And it is through abiding in his word, as Somnath led us in the word, that we, when we abide in the word of God, or we stay in the word of God, right, it is then that we, each one of us, is positioned. Can you get me? We are positioned. When we stay in the word, we are positioned to receive what God has in store for us. Did you get me? Was it too difficult to understand? When we stay in the word, when we abide in the word, we are positioned, we are brought to a place where we can receive more from God. Is that good? Because people are asking for prayer, let me this happen, let that happen. I want you to catch for yourself the way the greater increase of God in every way can come into your life. It's when we abide in the word. Right? Where are you in Jesus this morning? You are somewhere. Okay? You are somewhere. I am somewhere. Right? I believe every one of us has begun a journey with Jesus. When we give our heart to the Lord, when we receive him as our personal Savior, right? When you open your heart to the Lord, then you begin a journey with the Lord Jesus Christ. But that where you are this morning is not everything that God has for you. There is the more and the more and the more and the more of God. Is that good? You like to have the more of God? Yes. So there is, God is bigger than his book. There is more of God. Right? So I like you not to miss this more of God into your in your life. Did you get me? Everyone is giving attention to the word. So access to that unlimited increase in our personal life is directly related to the amount God's word abides in us. Did you get me? Did I make myself clear? Yes. Access to the unlimited more of God is directly related to how much of God's word is abiding in my heart. In my heart. Okay? So if you look at the early church, you find the way the early church moved in the book of Acts, right? Acts of the Apostles it's called. And it's amazing fruitfulness. They didn't even, in their day, the scriptures were still being written, right? And there was so much fruitfulness, because to them, they allowed the word of God, the what they had, they allowed the Holy Spirit to work on that word, and life just came out of them, bubbled out of them. Right? And it is not going to be any different now. That's God's heart for each of us. So let's not limit our God. Let's not fence him in. Let's not limit him to the two covers and the pages in between. God has more for us. His purpose for us, there is much more. And John 10:37, there are a few difficult scriptures, but I like you to go through them. John 10:37, Jesus said, if I don't do the works of the Father, don't believe me. Look at what he is saying. John 10:37, if I am not doing my Father's works, don't believe me. Isn't that a strange thing for Christ to say? Right? Because all the prophets in the Old Testament all pointed to the Christ. Creation itself witnessed that when Christ was being born, when that star came and the wise men came and said, we have seen the star of the Savior. Creation witnessed. Heaven came, angels came and said, told Mary, this is the Messiah. Isn't it? And there were two people praying in the church, Simon and Anna, old, but they were very attuned to the voice of God. It was revealed to them when Mary came. They looked at this baby and said, this is going to be the Messiah. Everybody is witnessing to the Christ, but Christ himself is saying, don't believe me if I don't do the works of the Father. Jesus is saying, let my works testify to mankind who I really am. So the works of the Father are really, really important. Because in the church today, we have got used to living without the works of the Father. We live by some systems, by religious worship, and we have systems. But the works of the Father we seem to be neglecting. But my heart is that the works of God be brought, be so much revealed and be present in the house of God. Is that good? Yes, we all need the works of the Father. So what did Jesus mean by the works of the Father? In the Gospel of John, I've read that there are over 20 to 21 times reference to the works of the Father. And 17 times or more in the Gospel of John, there is reference to miracles, signs and wonders are mentioned. That's part of the inheritance of the house of God. Miracles, signs, wonders. It's the inheritance of the house of God. Shalini said she saw the lampstand burning in this place. Our inheritance is miracles, signs and wonders. Because we worship a supernatural God. And we as followers are deemed to be supernatural people. You have a problem this morning before you. The answer to that is not in the natural. It's in the supernatural. We need to be a supernatural people. I think it's time we stopped always leaning to our understanding, working in the natural, manipulating, controlling, doing all these things. It's time we let go and let God handle our situations and allow the supernatural activity of God the Father begin to work in each of our lives. Are you with me this morning? Are you liking this? The possibility that God has for each one of you. So as a church, it's time we realized that if we don't do the works of the Father, our credibility to the outside world will be lost. Right? Is that okay? That's why I love my God. I worship Him. I serve Him. And I'm so thankful for this wind of the Holy Spirit that's present here at Brookside, healing the sick. Healing the sick. Doing impossible things. God is moving. Healing. It's His kindness and it's His comfort. It's not about a church or a glory for a man or for some group of people. It's God is in the house. That's the way we know God is in the house. When the supernatural is in effect. When there is the presence of God, nothing remains the same. Every natural inclination is moved out of place and the supernatural comes into being. Are you with me? Are you getting this? You and I need to be supernatural people. Don't settle down to the mundane. Don't settle down to the normal things. Go beyond. Allow your life to be extended by the supernatural God. Right? And in John 5:38, he's speaking to a religious community and he